Hey people, my name is Gerben and I've been selling and collecting vintage computers for a very, very long time. Normally we're unboxing at home, but today we're on the road and we're going to the south of the Netherlands. Also going to the Home Computer Museum in Helmond. Going to visit Bart, and we made a big a good deal on some computers. And after that, I'm going a little bit further, and I'm going to buy a vintage computer that everybody wants. This is one of the holy grails of old vintage computers. We will see what we'll get, and it will be a good trip today. Well, we got some interesting stuff from the Home Computer Museum. It's not the nicest computers, but it's also the price is good, so it's okay. We'll go through them one by one, and I will show you what we got. First one is an Olivetti M21. It's a bit trashed. There's supposed to be something more here, but it's not here, and it's all a bit loose. But I think somebody can do something with this. And the case of the computer is there, but it's a cabrio, so it lifts. Put it here. I think there's supposed to be something more here, but I'm not sure. And well, the power supply is there, the disk drives are there, the screen is there, and of course it's a little bit dirty, but that's not a problem. And we will see if somebody is willing to take on this very nice do-it-yourself project, I think. And people from Italy are very fanatic about their Olivetti's, so somebody will get happy from this all. And this is the machine when it's turned on. Well, there is some hope for this machine, I think. And I assume that the people who know how to fix these can see the screen and think, oh, this is easy, or maybe not. The next one is also a very poor puppy, I think. It's not complete, it's in parts, but it is vintage. So somebody will see the worth in it and want to buy this, I think. Because maybe you can fix it, and maybe you can make something else out of it. Let's have a look. This is the Bondwell 12, another CPM machine. First of all, it's missing the keyboard, of course, but the disk drives are here, the tube is here. Here you can put your disks, but it's very much in parts again. And there is no motherboard. It's missing. So there's no need to test this, because we know it won't do anything. But maybe you need the nice case, because I think it's a complete and unbroken case. So that would be useful to somebody. Before transport, I will of course put these in a safe place that they don't run around well in transport. Well, it used to be a computer and now it's just parts. Next computer is still trashed, it's still broken, but it's working. And MSX fanboys will be very happy with this one, because this is the ultimate Philips computer. When it's all nice and all working, it's a lot of money. I'm not really sure how this will do, but I'm told it was working. It has got one working drive, so at least one working drive. So we'll have a quick look. Maybe I have to tell you what you're looking at, because it's not really visible anymore. This is the Philips NMS8280, the video computer. It had video capabilities. Here are the slides for the screens and everything else. And here we have the power button. I think everything works, but it's all in bits and pieces. Two disk drives at the machine. And in the back we can see it's a 8280. Here we can see. Yes, you can see. And it has a lot of connections for digitizing. And it's one of the... It's the top model of the Philips line. But sadly this one is had a really, really rough life. And either somebody was uncareful enough to drop it, or I think maybe somebody tried to send it by mail, put it in a parcel, and if you don't pack these right, your front, it is very brittle, will be trashed all over. I've seen many computers like this, some even worse than this, and you have to be careful to pack your stuff very good. And with 16 years of experience, I know exactly how to do this, and it will not get damaged anymore. But this machine is a bit sad, I think. It's time to test this puppy. It was sold to me by the Home Computer Museum by Bart, and it was sold to me working, so we can assume it is. Something lights up. Oh, this is nice. It's searching for the disk. This all seems very, very well. With this machine, if you're at first getting a black screen, please don't panic, because there's a lot of sliders and stuff to move around. And here we are. It works fine. This device should be working, but it's not. But it's always possible with old vintage computers that it stops working. Doesn't matter. It's a nice computer, or somebody will think it's a nice computer. Well, the cartridge port works, of course, and this is always nice to see. This is playing Salamander. Now we're getting to the better stuff. I have to say that, of course, Bart is not selling rubbish stuff, because I only buy the broken parts from him. And the rest that he's selling is, of course, very, very nice, very good and clean computers. And next one is another one. And it's not really a computer. It's more like a word processor. It's not very uncommon in the Netherlands. And let's have a look. And here we have it. It's the Philips VideoWriter. It's word processor and printer all in one. It has a floppy drive, so you can store your great book, your writing, whatever. Let's see if it's working. Oh, we have to flip another fridge. Something is happening. This is nice. Oh, kill some lights. Here we go. Advice to do something with the disk drive. This seems very good. This is really a vintage Dutch machine because it's telling us in Dutch to put in a disk. Okay, we will put in a disk. It will think about the disk. This is not a Fido Writer disk. Of course it is not. Okay, and we're going to format it in the do. And to format it, we have to press the do button. Do. It's now being formatted. This is very nice. This was a long time ago that I worked with one of these. Jump, 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 jump. What are you doing? Okay, this is a disk error. But and the disk was not no. We'll try something else. We will do again. This is not right. This sometimes happens, of course. You saw my reaction. I was a bit startled. And here we have some nice smoke. But the most interesting part, of course, always is that the machine keeps working. The smell is getting worse. But this is the way to life. These things happen. One day you have a working machine, all fine and all nice. And the next, it goes kaboom. Okay, after the smoke is gone, there's still this nice machine and it's still working. We finally got a disk that works. I will kill the light and we can see what's on the screen. You can make your own documents and this is funny.
Yes, all nice.
So now we're getting to the nice computers. It's a nice little computer with an external disk drive. I just cleaned it up and let's have a look what it is. It's an Apple IIc with the computer, the external disk drive and the external power supply. I hope it's working. And it's a nice little computer. It was quite portable, quite small. You take it up and you pick it up and you can take it wherever you want to go. Of course, it would be more nice if it's even more nice than when the original monitor is also included, but you cannot have it all. So we'll hook this up and see what this machine can do. I've got it all hooked up and I've inserted a disk that I already had and we'll power it on. This all sounds very promising. And look at that. This is very nice. It makes us very happy. Let's try one of these. Let's try number one. Well, my life is very smoothly. There's never a problem in the world, of course. let's see if we can press return. Yeah, I'm not a mess. Look at that. The father is smoking in the house. How is this possible? This is very funny and very from a different time than we're now in. Well, that's the end of this video. I hope you enjoyed it. I enjoyed making these videos very much because it's a lot of fun to show people what's coming in, and every time there's something new, every week there's some other computers, and that's always like Christmas all over sometimes. Like, what's in the box? What am I gonna get? I know that in the beginning of the video I promised you there would be a very, very special and very expensive computer. There was not in this video. I'm sorry. I think it will be in the next one, or maybe the one after that, because this was already filled with the stuff that I got from Bart from the Home Computer Museum. Thank you, Bart. And it was good stuff. It was almost everything sold, and no, that's always good. If you did not already, please subscribe because that really helps. And I hope to see all of you next time. Bye bye.